And Leonard Scott, who took one 100 yards for a touchdown 2 weeks ago against Georgia, is waiting for him. Takes the short kickoff from the 10. Right up the middle, across the 30, and down at the 31. I'm Sean McDonald, along with Todd Blackledge and Michelle Tafoya. Delighted to have you with us for the most anticipated game in this stadium in several years. Gerald Dixon made the tackle on special teams for Alabama, and here comes T. Martin to lead the Tennessee offense. The senior from Mobile, Alabama, knocked around a bit in that victory over Georgia the last game for the Vols 2 weeks ago. Suffered a mild concussion that will not be affected today, we are told. He also bruised his hand. He's had a leg bruise, a sore shoulder. Well, the coaches say he's very close to 100%, if not at 100% for this battle. Throws a wide receiver screen to Cedric Wilson on the first play from scrimmage, and he's run down from behind by Miguel Merritt after a gain to the 35-yard line. The rest of the ball offensive starters. Jamal Lewis trying to get on track with Philip Crosby, the blocking fullback. Wilson, their leading receiver, with Martin and Finlayson, the rest of the backs and receivers. Up front, the veteran offensive line welcomes back Chad Clifton, who failed to start for the first time in 26 games against Georgia as he sat out after arthroscopic elbow surgery. He's back to join the veteran group. Second and six. Eric Parker, the motion man. Here's Jamal Lewis. Straight ahead to the 40-yard line. Tackled by Marvin Constant, the redshirt freshman middle linebacker. The strength of the Alabama defense is up front, particularly the tackles Kenny Smith and Cornelius Griffin. Kenny King, a true freshman, playing on the outside. We're also very young at linebacker, with the true freshman Salim Rashid, the redshirt freshman Constant, and the senior Merritt outside. Revamped secondary, Kelf Bailey starts at corner today with Milo Lewis. Miles and Dixon are the safeties. Alabama last in the SEC in defense. And Lewis burst through for a first down. Out to the 43-yard line, chopped down by Marvin Constant.
You know, Sean, I think Jamal Lewis, this is a real important game for him. It's a pride game for him. I mean, a lot of people think this season has been a disappointment for him, and his numbers have been way down, but everybody's talking about Sean Alexander, and Jamal Lewis, a very prideful guy.
With 3 seconds left, Miami on the verge of victory in dramatic come from behind fashion in Chestnut Hill, Massachusetts. With a late field goal, the Canes have taken the lead. Martin airing it out deep, incomplete. Looking for Eric Parker. Milo Lewis had the coverage. Let's get details on that BC Miami game from Tim Brando.
Sean, you may recall a couple of years ago, Miami had to overcome a 24-point deficit and barely win in overtime. Crossland, Andy Crossland, boots a 30-yarder today. They were down 28-0. A huge comeback. Only a couple of ticks remaining at Alumni Stadium.
And a big missed field goal by Boston College when it was 28-7 would have made it 31-7 in the fourth. Momentum seemed to swing after that miss. The pass incomplete. Good coverage by Kelf Bailey. The pass intended for the redshirt freshman Dante Stallworth.
You know, Ellis Johnson told us yesterday Bailey will start, but Gerald Dixon is the guy they're really trying to work into this position because he feels that if Bailey's on the field long enough, people are going to pick on him. Two pass plays in a row, Tennessee has gone after Bailey. He came up okay on both of them.
Well, if he's allowed to hold all the way down the field as he did on that play, he will be successful most of the afternoon. Leonard Scott, Bobby Graham come in as additional wide receivers for the balls on third down and 10. 2 minutes played, no score. Raucous sellout crowd in Tuscaloosa. The blitz didn't get Martin. And he crosses the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Cornelius Griffin knocked him down. The original pressure came from Darius Gilbert. And this is a tied defense that has struggled all year long. They really needed this early.
They needed some good plays early. They knew they had to take a few more chances. They blitzed up inside with both linebackers, and Jamal Lewis could only block one of them. You have one back, he can only get one. Good pressure by the Alabama defense on that third down.
David Leverton, the junior punter, has had a good year punting, 42 yards per punt. This is high and wobbly and short, but it takes a Tennessee bounce. And goes out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Just a 31-yard punt. Mike Dubose looking for his first win over Tennessee as head coach. He's riding his first three-game winning streak as a head coach. all three victories over ranked opponents. He hadn't defeated a ranked opponent as head coach in 2+ seasons prior to the 3 in a row against Arkansas, Florida, and Ole Miss. Andrew Zhao is the quarterback, the sophomore from Lake Butler, Florida. 9 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. Led the Bama offense to a turnover-free performance against Ole Miss. Quick hitter to Freddie Millins. He's emerged as a threat. He fumbled, but it went out of bounds. And it looks like a first down out near the 39-yard line. Eric Westmoreland and Deion Grant combined to take down Millins.
Sean, I really think Freddie Millins is the key to the ball game today for Alabama. He and Antonio Carter, their ability at wide receiver to beat man-to-man coverage. You see him break a couple tackles. He's very dangerous after he catches the football. He's a former quarterback in high school. He's very elusive. And Tennessee, they make no bones about how they're going to play defense. They're going to come after you. They're going to play a lot of tight man-to-man.
And they will have to keep an eye on Millins. Looking for his 4th straight 100-yard receiving game. His emergence has helped give Alabama with that spread offense the dual threats, the passing game, and the great Sean Alexander tailback looking for his 7th consecutive 100-yard rushing game. Flags down before the play. Referee is Al Ford.
Oh, a snap. Movement by the offensive line, 5 yards. Still first down.
We welcome those of you who watched Miami come from behind to defeat Boston College to sold out Bryant-Denny Stadium in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Top 10 matchup between number 5 Tennessee and number 10 Alabama. Scoreless in the first quarter. Tennessee punted after its first possession. Now Alabama's on offense for the first time. First down at 15 after procedure penalty. Sean Alexander out to the 36. Dominique Stevenson made the tackle. For those of you just joining us, Alabama leads the all-time series. Most of the series, the game was played on the 3rd Saturday of October, and it was one of the great traditions in college football. That hasn't always been the case in recent years. 4 out of the last 5, they've not played on the 3rd Saturday in October. Tennessee's won the last 4, looking for its first ever 5-game winning streak in this rivalry. Great border rivalry between 2 southern powerhouses. Long pass, too long. Looking for Shamari Buchanan was Andrew Zhao, and Dwayne Goodrich had the coverage. Alabama undefeated in the conference at 4-0, 5-1 overall. The 1 loss in the final seconds to Louisiana Tech. Mississippi State also undefeated in the West. 4 teams with 1 loss in the SEC East, including Tennessee. The 1 Tennessee loss to Florida. So Tennessee is going to need a little help along the way. And it's going to advance back to the SEC championship game in Atlanta. That's what these fans in Alabama have their hearts and minds set on, a trip back to the SEC title game. 3rd down and 12 out of the spread. Low snap handled by Zhao. Under pressure, the dump off to Alexander. He's going to have to do it himself. And he came up about a yard and a half short at the 46, where Eric Westmoreland stopped him. Sean Ellis put the heat on Zhao and forced the quick dump off. So each team will punt after its first possession as Patrick Morgan comes on for the Tide.
I think we saw right away how Tennessee is going to try to play this game. They're not real fancy. They're going to pressure the quarterback. They're going to play man-to-man, and they're going to put more defenders in the box to defend the run. They're going to put the ball in Andrew Zhao's hands to beat man-to-man coverage.
Breeze at the back of Morgan. Deion Grant back for the punt. The hit at the 18. Roll to the 17, and it's down there. A 37-yard punt down by Marvin Brown. No score in the first quarter in Tuscaloosa.
We saw the old Jamal.
And here he is on first down, powering across the 20, out to the 21. Gain of 4. Here's a look back at the action 2 weeks ago. Jamal Lewis helping to lead Tennessee to its most impressive victory of the season over the University of Georgia.
Well, what he does best is run north-south powerfully, breaking tackles. He only had 79 yards last year. He's only had 1 game over 100 this season, but he really looked like we used to see him run north and south with a lot of explosion.
Four straight games without reaching 100 for Lewis. He did have more than 100 in the opener against Wyoming. A low throw and a good catch by Neil Johnson. The unfortunate part of that for Tennessee, had it not been a low throw and Johnson been able to stay on his feet, he had a lot of running room. But Martin had to get rid of it quickly under pressure from Reggie Grimes. And that's the first catch of the season for Johnson, the junior tight end from Nashville.
Well, they ran bootleg. You see the tight end in here. He's showing block and then he's going to release. The Alabama defense plays the play fake, and just T. Martin didn't get his feet set to make a good throw to allow his tight end to run with it.
That's just the second career catch for Johnson, his first since 1997. He had an 11-yard grab against Georgia. There's Lewis again on first down, out to the 37. Kendall Moorhead wrapped him up.
You know, you're talking about Jamal Lewis, and certainly a lot of people have thought this season that he's been a disappointment, and I think he is now getting back to where he's comfortable with the knee, where the offensive line is playing a little better, and he's a very prideful guy. I mean, he's a guy that everybody talked about, Sean Alexander. This is an important game for Jamal Lewis. I would be very surprised if he doesn't play very well all day.
Four carries, 18 yards for Jamal. No score, first quarter. Second and four, the pump fake, the throw to the sideline, and it is caught! Batted around and caught by Parker. Milo Lewis, the defender, they each had a great shot at it, but it was Parker on the ricochet who pulled it in for a gain of 23.
Well, both guys made a great play. Milo Lewis did a nice job of getting his head around at the last minute and getting a hand on the football, but great concentration by Parker staying with the football. Randy Sanders, the offensive coordinator, says this guy has come along better than we expected. He's made more plays this season than we thought he was going to.
They've been looking for a second wide receiver to emerge. There's Lewis, tripped up by Milo Lewis. And Parker has been that receiver coming on. Another reason why the offense hasn't been as crisp this year for Tennessee as last year, they lost Peerless Price to the NFL, and he was a big play wide receiver on the outside. Wilson's more of a possession type. They're still looking for that consistent deep threat, but Parker has given them a nice tandem now.
He's done a nice job for me. Five catches in the first half in their last game against Georgia, including a 34-yarder on the first possession to kind of set the tone for the offense.
Second and seven, Tide showing blitz. They come on the blitz. Lewis trying to run through it, but Salim Rashid was able to pull him down. A true freshman from Birmingham.
Salim Rashid made the tackle for Alabama.
There's Rashid. Ellis Johnson, the defensive coordinator, says he's absolutely phenomenal for a freshman. Thinks he has a chance to be one of the all-time Alabama greats at that position when he leaves. His brother, a former Mr. Football in Alabama, now plays at Duke. Third down. Tennessee has struggled on third down, just ninth in the SEC, converting 32% of the time. They need three on this third down. Play action pass. Martin in trouble. And down back at the 40. Chased down by Kendall Moorhead and Marvin Constant. And the punting unit comes on.
The best way to pressure T. Martin is to get pressure inside. Watch right in here. The pressure comes up inside by Kenny Smith. Good up the field pressure. T. Martin is most dangerous running when he can run straight up the field, not to the outside. That job, good job by Kenny Smith, forcing him to the perimeter.
David Leverton to punt, the Alabama 40 on fourth down and nine. Long count. They're going to take the delay game penalty. Perhaps give Leverton a little bit more room with which to work. We're trying to draw Alabama offside. Well, you were down on the field before the game. There is a pretty stiff breeze in the stadium here today, and it looks like Tennessee is going right into the teeth of it here in the first quarter.
Yeah, and I think it's going to become more of a factor as the day goes on. You know, I was up here in the booth a lot earlier in the game, and you couldn't feel it up here, but down on the field, it definitely is a factor, and particularly it'll be a factor in the kicking game.
Philip Fulmer knows all about this great rivalry. Played in it, was an assistant coach in it, now the head coach. He grew up Winchester, Tennessee, right along the Alabama border. A lot of Bama fans nearby. Leverton trying for the coffin corner, and he has it at the 1 yard line. No score in the first quarter in Tuscaloosa.
force you to throw the football, but you still have to run it to keep them honest.
They look for the outside threats. Millens and Carter. Alexander gets nothing on first down. The safety Fred White up around the line of scrimmage. You expect that they'll try to take advantage of that man-to-man coverage of Tennessee with Millens and Carter today.
Yeah, I think both those guys, Freddie Millens and Antonio Carter, are guys who can make things happen when they catch the football, and they're good against man-to-man coverage. Now, it's going to be very tough in this particular position of the field with their backs against the wall, but that's going to be a key in the ball game. Their ability to throw the football against man coverage, because Tennessee's going to definitely try to stop the run first.
Second down. Almost 10 to go. Tim Bowens comes in at wide receiver. Alexander took the deep pitch. First down out near the 17-yard line. He's averaging 156 yards per game rushing, leading the nation in all-purpose yards, and he has a 14-yard pickup there.
When you want to run the football at Alabama, run left behind big Chris Samuel, the tight end in there. Terry Jones Jr. did a great job of sealing the left side, and that has been their best running play. The toss sweep to the left, normally to the short side of the field. Sean Alexander, a huge run right there from his own end zone.
One of their best running plays, but kind of risky out of the end zone like that. Give the ball to Alexander against the defense that has stuffed the run regularly this year. Zao wings it to Antonio Carter, the true freshman, driven back at the 20-yard line by Eric Westmoreland and Dominique Stevenson. The Alabama starters on offense, Alexander with McClintock regularly leading the way, McCadley and Millens the wideouts, and Terry Jones Jr. the tight end. And an experienced offensive line. Philip Fulmer, the Tennessee coach, says Samuels is the best offensive lineman in the country, and few would argue with his performances of late. That offensive line with now more than 7,800 career snaps combined. Second and seven, under 5 minutes left in the first quarter. Time throws to Alexander with a nice tackle by Eric Westmoreland, and Alexander broken free from that. He was going to run for a while. Tennessee defensively, they lost Billy Ratliff to a broken leg up front, so John Henderson, the sophomore, steps in with Darwin Walker at the tackles. Overstreet and Ellis, excellent pass rushers. Dominique Stevenson coming back from an injured knee. Raynock Thompson from hernia surgery 12 days ago. In the secondary, it's Lott, White, Grant, and Goodrich. Deion Grant leads the nation in interceptions with 6.
Well, that play there shows you a little bit about Eric Westmoreland. A lot of teams, that's a mismatch, Sean Alexander on a linebacker, but not for Eric Westmoreland. He can cover man-to-man.
Third down, a short two, more like a yard and a half. Alexander cuts back, doesn't get it. Out to the 26-yard line, but he's about a half yard shy of the first down. Fred White again up from his safety spot, the senior from Griffin, Georgia.
When you try to defend a great runner, you've got to make sure you take care of the backside. Don't overrun plays. Watch Fred White stay at home, and as Alexander tries to cut it back, he's right there ready to make the tackle. This is a very fast defense, and they have a tendency to overrun things at times, but against a great back, you've got to be disciplined in your gap responsibility.
Patrick Morgan's first spot, not all that special with the breeze, 37 yards. Flag down on the play. Line drive punt. Will Piker back to the 25, and he's tackled by Sean Toure, their special team standout, at the 29. A 49-yard punt and a 4-yard return, but there is a flag down near the line of scrimmage. Now for the referee.
And a 4-yard return.
Will tell us about it.
Defense, offside, 5 yards, first down.
That'll give them a first down. It was fourth down and less than a yard. A very costly early mistake by Tennessee.
I think somebody lined up offside, Sean. I don't think anybody jumped on the snap or before the snap, but the way that flag was thrown, somebody was lined up offsides, and as soon as the ball was snapped, the flag came down. Take a look here. It's hard to tell there. The only guy I could think would be the guy lined up over the gunner, the closest to the sideline, may have had his face gear across the line of scrimmage.
First down, Bama now at the 31-yard line. No score under 3 minutes left in the first quarter. The pitch to Alexander, following McClintock. First down and more. Out to the 46-yard line. Wayne Goodrich, the cornerback, called upon to make the stop. 15 yards on the run for Alexander, the senior from Florence, Kentucky.
Sean, you mentioned Dustin McClintock, but watch the wide receiver, number 80, Jason McCadley, gets a huge block, too. McClintock got his block, but McCadley had come in motion to get involved in the blocking scheme and did a great job to spring Alexander. Two very nice blocks on the perimeter by the wide receiver and the fullback.
34 yards rushing on five carries for Alexander. 100 plus in every game. Last man to rush for 100 against Tennessee was Alexander last October in Knoxville in Tennessee's victory over the Tide. Alexander tackled this time by Sean Ellis and John Henderson, and here's Michelle Tafoya.
Well, Sean, as you mentioned, coming into the season, it was Jamal Lewis who was projected to be a Heisman candidate. But with Sean Alexander taking the focus away from him, Lewis had a little prediction about Sean today. He said, if all of our guys are healthy, he'll meet a real defense this time. Our defense is ready. They love to go against good running backs, and this will show how good Alexander really is. Guys.
Raynock Thompson, the Tennessee linebacker, said that Alexander will be the second best linebacker that the Vol defense has faced this year. So we go against Jamal Lewis every day in practice, and he's the best. And we'll see.
This is a tough situation for Tennessee. Sean Ellis is coming off the field injured. They've already lost Billy Ratliff, one of their key inside defenders, and Sean Ellis has been their most productive defensive lineman playing the defensive end.
Ratliff out for the year with a fractured fibula. Including his career, it was an injury-filled career for Billy Ratliff. Bernard Jackson, number 56, has committed defensive end. Sophomore from Louisville in for Ellis, and a timeout called by Andrew Zhao with the play clock down to two. Second and eight upcoming for the Tide in a scoreless game with under 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Rattled and roll on this winning streak. Three in a row over ranked opponents, trying to make it four. On second and eight after the timeout, they come out in the spread. And they set up the screen to Alexander. A looted one would-be tackler across midfield to the Tennessee 49, where Bernard Jackson pulled them down. Jackson in for Sean Ellis. Michelle Tafoya tells us from the sideline that Ellis has a bruised knee, but he is expected to return.
That's good news for Tennessee, because Sean really has been very productive for them this year. Leads them in sacks, leads them in pressures and big plays. And particularly when you lose a guy like Billy Ratliff, who is such an emotional leader and a lot of experience, you've got to have those other guys really raise their level of play. And they've gotten that from Ellis and Darwin Walker.
Andrew Zhao, 5 out of 6 passing for 32 yards. Third down and 5. He throws, caught by Jason McCadley. Gets belted very close to a first down. Needed to reach the 44, and that's just about where he is. Bernard Jackson, Deion Grant, Fred White. All there to deliver a pretty good blow to Jason McCadley. It is a first down.
Sean, we've seen this for the last couple weeks. Alabama up front, very good at protecting their quarterback, Andrew Zhao, and giving him good sight lanes down the field. McCadley needs to kind of lower that shoulder when he gets to the sideline like that.
He's a Tennessee native from Oak Ridge, Tennessee. And with a little bit of a headache, as you might expect. After the catch, 10th play of this Alabama possession, final 30 seconds of the opening quarter. Alexander stopped for a loss by Eric Westmoreland.
Sean Draper was in motion and ran right by Westmoreland. Just ignored him, and nobody picked up Westmoreland. Had to be a bust on the part of Sean Draper.
And it'll be the final play of the first quarter. No score. We'll return to Bryant Denny Stadium right after this message and a word from your local station. Tennessee and Alabama scoreless after one quarter, playing before a record crowd. Largest crowd in the history of the state of Alabama. 86,869 at Bryant Denny Stadium. Tennessee playing here for the first time since 1930. On second down, Freddie Millins picks up the first down and more. Knocked out of bounds by Mickey Allen along the far sideline, but he's all the way to the 26-yard line. That's a gain of 19. Again today, Todd, we've seen this a lot lately from Alabama. Nice mixture with Charlie Stubbs calling the plays of the run and pass.
Run and pass and different formations, different personnel groups are doing a nice job of keeping the defense off balance. And Andrew Zhao off to a very good start here in the ballgame so far.
Talk about this being the first trip here for Tennessee since 1930. Alabama's always played Tennessee in Birmingham since then. This year, the game moved back here. Last time Tennessee was here, Paul Bear Bryant was in high school. Alexander started to slip as he saw Raynock Thompson approaching, and Alexander went down for no gain. The stadium held 12,000 people when last Tennessee came to Tuscaloosa in 1930. They did bring in 8,000 extra seats and an overflow crowd of more than 20,000. Wallace Wade was the Alabama coach. Tennessee coach by then Major Robert Nealon. They came into the game. Did the Vols riding a 30-game unbeaten streak led by Bobby Dodd. Alabama hit stars like tackle Frank Howard. J.B. Ears Whitworth went on the coaching careers. Alabama won that day 18-6. Later that year won their third national championship. Zhao throws, juggled, and dropped by the tight end, Terry Jones Jr. Looked like he was tipping that around forever. And he's had a tough time catching the ball in recent weeks.
Terry Jones hasn't had a catch the last 3 weeks, and the tight end has not really been a factor in all this offensive production for Alabama. That's a catch Terry's got to make. It was a little bit high, but he was able to get both hands on the football. And obviously the Tennessee defense kind of forgot about the tight end on that play. He's got to come up with that catch and make a play.
His dad, Terry Sr., was a great player here at Alabama, went on to the NFL with the Green Bay Packers, and is now the strength and conditioning coach for the Alabama football team. Three, and there is dad. Three of the seven catches for Terry Jr. came in one game against Houston. On the blitz, out, dumps it off for Alexander. Lots of running room. Touchdown!
Coming right in his face, and he knew right where he wanted to go. Sean Alexander, good pickup by the blitz, and Sean Alexander got a great block by Freddie Millins down the field to get him into the end zone.
Lost the ball after he crossed the goal line. Ryan Klugner adds the extra point, and Alabama leads 7-0 on a 26-yard touchdown reception by the nation's leading scorer, Sean Alexander, who averages 17 points per game. The season, they don't mind starting at the one. Of course, the offside by Tennessee on the punt kept it alive. Leonard Scott, one of the fastest men in the nation, a great track athlete, with a good kickoff return out to the 34. Lane Bearden, the kicker, had to run him out. Alabama spent an extra time this week working on kickoff coverage. They've had difficulty. And Leonard Scott with a quality return there. He's leading the SEC in kickoff returns at 33 per run back.
Bearden did two good things there. He kicked it where they wanted. They want to kick it left. They made some switches in their coverage teams and put some more guys on the left side. But Leonard Scott ran all the way back to the other side, and Bearden did a nice job getting him out of bounds.
A key play last year in Tennessee's win over Alabama in Knoxville was a Peerless Price kickoff return for a touchdown. Lewis kicked over some legs in the backfield. A loss on the play. Tomorrow, the NFL on CBS goes for two. First, Brian Griese and the Broncos try to continue their comeback when they take on Drew Bledsoe and the Patriots. And in the nightcap, Doug Flutie drives the Buffalo Bills into Ricky Waters and the Seattle Seahawks. Or Keyshawn Johnson leads the Jets against the Raiders. Check local listings, beginning with Jim, Craig, Randy, and Jerry on the NFL Today at noon Eastern. Chad Clifton injured on the play, grabbing at his right arm. Yeah. He's had elbow surgery within the last couple of weeks to remove some fragments from his elbow. The senior from Martin, Tennessee, grew up a big Vol fan, was recruited by Alabama. Gene Stallings came for a home visit when Coach Stallings left the house. Someone had written in shaving cream on his car, go Vols. He had a pretty good idea then he wasn't going to be able to recruit Clifton successfully. CBS Sports coverage of the Home Depot College football will continue after this word from your local station.
Extended that right elbow. He says it is settling down and he's going to try to go back in. Back upstairs to Sean and Todd.
All right, Michelle, Reggie Coleman, who played the entire game last week against Georgia 2 weeks ago, actually. They had a week off last week. He's in a tackle for Clifton. The screen and nothing doing for Jamal Lewis. Saleem Rashid led the Tide defenders. Several crimson shirts in the neighborhood. Let's take a look now at our Sun America virtual playbook.
Well, T. Martin can throw the football, but T. Martin is also very dangerous as a runner. Not necessarily a designed run, but if you play a lot of man coverage against their spread formations, and if you vacate the middle of the field, T. Martin will take off, and he'll go up the field. Six rushes for 49 yards against Georgia. So far, Alabama pressuring him inside.
Third and 11, deafening noise from the record crowd. Martin stripped of the ball by Kenny Smith. The T got it back.
Sean, they did something different with Kenny Smith here. He's a defensive tackle and plays inside, but on this particular rush, they put him outside, working against the new guy in the ballgame, Reggie Coleman, and he went right around Coleman and got the sack and the strip.
David Leverton with the punt. Fair catch called for and made by Freddie Millens at the 26-yard line, a 46-yard punt by Leverton. 3 minutes played in the second quarter. Alabama goes back on offense, leading 7-0. In here. Blitz off the corner. Westmoreland again there to trip up Sean Alexander. And Westmoreland still down, grabbing at his legs.
You know, we talked about containing Sean Alexander. How do you do it? You first have to overload the box, put more defenders than you can block. Second, gap responsibilities. Don't let him cut back. He has great vision. And even if you do one and two well, you still have to do number three. You have to have good fundamentals tackling, because Sean Alexander is a lot more powerful than he appears. He has great vision. He's very slippery, and he breaks a lot of arm tackles.
Well, this terrific Tennessee defense starting to be affected by injuries. Billy Ratliff out for the year with a broken leg. Sean Ellis suffered a bruised knee. He has returned to the lineup today for Tennessee. And now Westmoreland injured on this play.
Watch Samuels as he is carrying out his block. It just looks like he kind of kicks or leg whips into Eric Westmoreland. Obviously not an intentional thing, but caught it right on the kneecap.
Nine carries, 35 yards now for Alexander. Seven of his nine rushes for 2 yards or less. He's had a couple that have broken out. Westmoreland, a junior from Jasper, Tennessee. Great running back in high school at Marion County. Rushed for nearly 6,000 yards in high school. Led his team to 3 state championships. An overall record of 56-1 when he was in high school.
And he is really a key guy to this defense, Sean, because of his speed and his ability to cover in the spread formations. They don't have to necessarily go to a nickel defense or put an extra defensive back on the field. He can still have the toughness of a linebacker, but he's got the speed to cover a slot receiver or a running back like Sean Alexander. So if they lose him, that's a key loss for this
yes.
Tennessee defense because of his versatility.
He's very experienced. His replacement is not. Anthony Sessions has come in, number 22, the junior. A junior college transfer in his first year with Tennessee. He's made just 8 tackles all season. And 4 of those were the first game of the year against Wyoming. And some of the reserves had playing time in a one-sided game. Second and 10, out of the gun, Zau against the blitz. Millens. Swung down at the 30. They expect a lot of screens, wide receiver screens to the Tennessee defense today, and they've reacted pretty well to them so far. Mickey Allen made the tackle.
John Chavis told us whenever Alabama senses they're getting too much pressure, this is what they like to run to alleviate that pressure. And Tennessee is well aware that Alabama likes that wide receiver screen. That time a good tackle after the catch to stop it to a short game.
And Millen's hoping for a record fourth straight 100-yard game. He's the only player in Bama history with three straight 100-yard receiving games. Zau trying to get away from Ellis. Throws on the run into a crowd. Shamari Buchanan wanted a flag. It was broken up by Andre Lott. And Alabama will be forced to punt.
Zau was pretty lucky there because Andre Lott got a good break on the football and Shamari Buchanan did not come back to his quarterback. I think he was more conscious of staying beyond the first down marker and he almost got his quarterback intercepted there.
Morgan punting into the breeze now and Eric Parker returned to punt 69 yards for a touchdown in their 1-point win against Memphis is back for the punt for the ball. Bad punt. Nearly hit Sean Toure and it goes out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Just a 30-yard boot for the senior from Birmingham, Patrick Morgan. 7-0 Alabama, but good field position for the Vols. Two top 10 teams played head-to-head right here in Tuscaloosa. Give you a little time to think about it. First and 10 Tennessee. It's own 40. Travis Henry at a tailback. And he powers out near the 45. Kenny Smith made the tackle. Henry, the leading ball carrier last year when Jamal Lewis went down in the fourth game with a knee injury that ended his season. Henry helped lead them to the national championship when he rushed for 970 yards for his career, now over 1,100. Ellis Johnson, the defensive coordinator for Bama, said yesterday he'd be the starting tailback on 8 or 9 teams at least in the SEC.
Had over 102 touchdowns against Alabama last year in the ballgame.
Play action fake to Henry. Martin throws to the far sideline. Bama coaches saying it was an incomplete pass, but they're going to rule it a catch to the 44. Of Alabama and a first down for Dante Stallworth with Reggie Miles in coverage. And let's check in again with Michelle.
Well, you guys, Eric Westmoreland, they think has a bruised knee. They're icing it now. They're going to watch it. They have looked at it very extensively to determine that it was nothing as serious as a torn ACL or MCL, and they have eliminated those ideas. But they are going to keep an eye on it. He is questionable. Back to you.
And good news on the injury front for Tennessee that Chad Clifton has returned to the game at tackle. Martin hit as he threw, and it fell incomplete. Almost intercepted. Kenny Smith again, bringing the heat. The junior from Meridian, Mississippi, has quickly acquainted himself with T. Martin.
Sean, Kenny Smith got such a great jump on this snap. Watch how quickly he gets off the football. He just beat the entire offensive line off the ball. Watch him here. He anticipates the snap count and is across the line before Weary can even get a hat on him. And he forced the quick throw by T. Martin. Great anticipation by Kenny Smith.
Travis Henry bounced off the hit of Saleem Rashid. Was able to gain a couple. When it looked like it might be a loss on the play. But it'll be third down. And about 9 to go for Tennessee first down.
Well, we've seen Alabama for a couple weeks now, Sean, and I think the defense, they came to play a little bit more today than we've seen in the last couple weeks. They're playing with a little more fire, a little more aggressive. Ellis Johnson, defensive coordinator, said they'd have to take a few more chances. They've tried to pressure Tennessee a little bit more today, and it's been pretty successful.
Bobby Graham in at wide receiver. Movement. And now the flag and the whistle. Cornelius Griffin was doing a dance. And finally the flag did come.
Contact by the defense. 5 yards.
Now that's a key mistake. From third down and 8 to 3rd and 3.
Well, Cornelius Griffin obviously not watching the football, listening to T. Martin's voice and trying to guess on the snap count. Kenny Smith got a great jump a couple plays ago. That time he got caught.
Third down, a very short 4. Martin with all of that and then some. Inside the 20. was the concern you talked about that the Alabama coaches had with the ability of Martin to pull it down and run.
Well, this is a design quarterback draw, and he is very dangerous. You see him following the block of his fullback. He knew right away he was running. Take three steps back. You got a lead block by your fullback. And T. Martin is a big physical guy at 6'3", 215 pounds with good speed. Tough to bring down in the secondary.
He was the SEC Player of the Week for that performance against Georgia. Rushed for 49 yards in that game and three touchdowns. Travis Henry tackled by Marvin Constant at the 15. A gain of three as we go under 8 minutes left in the first half with Alabama leading 7-0.
One of the things that Tennessee has not been very good at this year has been their productivity in the red zone. Only 52% touchdowns. And a lot of turnovers. Now last game against Georgia in the first half, 4 for 4 in the red zone, or orange zone as they like to call it, with four touchdowns, and T. Martin ran for three of those touchdowns.
Henry remains the tailback. Will Bartholomew the fullback. He follows Bartholomew, and Henry is down near the 9, looks to be about a half yard short of the first down.
Boy, that's just good power football, Sean. I mean, Alabama had a lot of defenders committed to stop the run. Tennessee said, we're going to run it anyway. We're going to toss it to our big tailback, Travis Henry. Got a good block by the fullback, and then he lowered his shoulders and knocked over a couple guys. That is just in-your-face power football.
Henry, the junior from Frostproof, Florida, had an unbelievable high school career. As a senior, rushed for 4,087 yards. Phillip Crosby, the fullback now. Henry again. Close to the first down. Marvin Constant made the tackle. They are likely going to have to bring on the chains for this one.
Marvin Constant made the tackle.
I think he got the first down because he turned his shoulders in between the two defenders. There were two guys there to meet him in the hole, and Travis Henry did a nice instinctive thing by just kind of turning his shoulders and slipping between them. Running in short yardage is a skill, and watch Travis Henry as there's two tied defenders. He just turns his shoulders and slips between them.
He's short of the first down by inches.
My eyesight failed me again.
Well, we'll check the prescription. Phillip Fulmer didn't hesitate. He's going to go for the first down. And Mike Dubose has been looking for big plays from his defense throughout the season. Hasn't received many. Here's a chance for one.
Jamal Lewis in now on this fourth down play in place of Travis Henry.
They have Lewis in with Phillip Crosby. And Will Bartholomew lined up to the right. Lewis up and over for the first down. That's pretty impressive leaping ability.
Mm-hmm.
At about 235 pounds, Jamal Lewis. They say stronger and even a little bit faster after the knee surgery with all the time that he spent in the weight room while he was sidelined.
You're a middle linebacker like Marvin Constant. You know they're coming right at you. First the fullback's going to come at you, and then the tailback over the top. Phillip Fulmer likes that call on fourth down.
10th play of the drive, which began at the Tennessee 40. They're looking for the tying touchdown. Travis Henry down near the 5. Marvin Constant again made the stop. He's been in there with regularity. We'll avoid the temptation to say constantly. Redshirt freshman from Tuscaloosa, the middle linebacker for the Crimson Tide. He was competing with Travis Carroll. Was the starter last year, middle linebacker, to be the starter again, and Carroll surprised them the offseason when he announced he was leaving, transferring back to his home state, University of Florida. Second and goal, Henry remains the tailback. Might in the play action fake as running room gets a block from Neil Johnson and scores a touchdown.
Okay.
This is what T. Martin did to Georgia in the orange zone, is run the bootleg. You're running the football with some success. Watch all the defense follow the fake to the tailback Henry. And T. Martin, when he got outside, got a nice block by Neil Johnson, the tight end. He was the intended receiver, but as soon as he saw T. wanted to run, he peeled back and got Darius Gilbert with the block and enabled Martin to get in the end zone. You run the football, it sets up the bootleg.
Alex Walls adds the extra point. Fifth rushing touchdown of the season for T. Martin. He now has more rushing touchdowns than passing touchdowns. He has four through the air, and the game is tied. David Leverton kicks off for Tennessee after the Volunteer touchdown. Freddie Millins across the 30. And again, the kicker Leverton had to make the tackle. Bama fans want a flag for a late hit. 32 yards on the return for Millins. They might want to line up Leverton at safety. He's been called upon to make a couple of tackles here. His was clean. They thought there was a late hit after Leverton took him out.
Well, he continued to ride him out, and then they threw him down.
Yeah.
And they very lucky that they didn't call that for an unnecessary roughness after the play. Good play by Leverton.
Just was way out of bounds when he swung him down.
Yeah.
Of course, being the kicker and the punter.
How many times you get to make the tackle?
He doesn't have much experience knowing where he is when he makes the tackle. Although he has a little bit more experience today than he'd like and Coach Fulmer would like.
You know, and interesting too, Sean, special teams in a big ball game, just as important as offense and defense. Both touchdowns set up by a mistake in the kicking game. Short punt by Alabama led to Tennessee's touchdown, and the penalty on Tennessee on a punt led to Alabama's touchdown.
Sean Alexander on first down. Ball fans will also remember Leverton made a big tackle, some say game-saving tackle, in the national championship game against Florida State. The Fiesta Bowl, Dominique Stevenson made this tackle on Alexander. Well, you've had time to think about the Aflac trivia question. I'll give you one clue. The last time Alabama was in the top 10 was 96, so it was at least 96 or before. And the answer is, did you know that?
I did not know that.
Number six, Penn State. You were gone by then.
Yes, I was. Good team, great defensive football team. They didn't score a lot of points that year, but they played great defense, ended up beating Miami in the Fiesta Bowl.
Andrew Zhao out of the gun on second down. Nice leaping catch by Millens. He lunges toward the 45. Close to a first down. Wrapped up by Bernard Jackson. You know what else happened on that date when Penn State played here against Alabama?
No.
A date many of us will never forget. The ball rolled past Bill Buckner. Wasn't just Bill's fault. Everybody always blames Bill. There were a lot of other miscues in that game. And the Mets won and went on to win the World Series. Wasn't a great day for Bama fans. Wasn't a great day for Red Sox fans. Millens just short. But Alexander picks up the first down and breaks free to the 35 of Tennessee.
Sean, this had a chance to blow up in the backfield because Anthony Sessions, watch him right here, how quickly he gets in underneath the block of the fullback, almost causes a fumble in the backfield. But then Sean Alexander, again, the vision, the ability to break tackles. If you don't tackle him fundamentally, he's going to kill you. Unbelievable how a game can, or a play can go from a disaster to a huge play. Sean Alexander last week, 120 of his 214 yards after initial contact, saw it again on that play.
And he got him with the initial contact that time behind the line of scrimmage. The surge led by John Henderson, the sophomore from Nashville. So the 21-yard run by Alexander followed by a loss.
Good penetration, good anticipation by the Tennessee defense. Watch how quickly they're off the ball and up the field. John Henderson right there. I think Andrew Zhao, Sean, needs to change up his snap count a little bit because Tennessee is getting good pressure up the field. They're anticipating the snap count a little bit. The linebackers, the outside linebackers, are just charging up the field inside the fullback. He's got to use the snap count a little better.
12 carries, 57 yards for Alexander. Zhao under pressure from Will Overstreet. Dumped it off incomplete short of Antonio Carter, and now Zhao is not getting up.
See, he's not 100% from the play that Sean Alexander broke on the short yardage play. He got hit by Anthony Sessions a couple plays ago, and I don't think his ankle is 100%. And now he goes down on it again. And it's obviously bothering him a little bit, but it wasn't hurt, I don't think, on that play. It was hurt when Anthony Sessions almost caused the fumble in the backfield.
Tyler Watts, the redshirt freshman, is the backup quarterback. He saw action the first four games of the year. They wanted to get him in every game to get him some experience because he's a highly touted prospect. He has not played in the last two games, even though they planned to get him in. They couldn't get him into the tight ball games against Florida and Ole Miss. And he'll help Zhao to his feet.
Go back to two plays ago when Anthony Sessions came into the backfield and almost caused the fumble. Right there is where Andrew Zhao's right ankle got fallen on by Sessions, and that's where he hurt it. And then he re-aggravated it on that particular sack.
Tough call here now for the Bama coaches. It's definitely an ordinarily a passing situation, third down and 12, but Watts is just coming into the game. And for the season, for his career, 4 out of 11.
I'd throw it to the end zone. I mean, at the worst case scenario, it's like a punt.
He is tripped up. They got him around the ankles and he stumbled back to the 40-yard line, but it's a sack for Tennessee. And likely a punting situation. Anthony Sessions, who came in when Eric Westmoreland left with the bruise, has been a factor, and he was the man who upended Watts.
They're starting to create some confusion up front for Alabama. They're moving their people around. They're not bringing that many people, but they're bringing them from places that Alabama is not expecting. And that time Sessions got in there again and got the sack on Tyler Watts.
The punt unit's been a very long time around the coaches over there, and they're looking into delay a game penalty. 1 second on the play clock, and that's a penalty.
You know, I think coaches just expect the other team to take a nap right here, because I mean, you just decline the penalty. They take the penalty because they want to get a little more distance to kick, and the defense just declines the penalty and makes you line up and kick it from the same spot. So,
well, the way Morgan's kicked the ball so far, and the fact he's going to the breeze, I'm not sure they would want to go back 5 yards. They obviously did because they intentionally took the penalty. But into this breeze, and with the struggles he's had today, 40-yard line might not be so bad. Now they're on the 45. It's going to take a pretty good boot into the breeze to get them inside the 10. Deion Grant waiting for the punt at the 11-yard line. 7-7 game, 1:27 left in the half. Tennessee has all three of its timeouts left. There's a better effort by Morgan. Can they get it at the one? No, they dropped it into the end zone.
John Toure had it. I mean, it was in perfect position. Was right there to catch the ball off the bounce and just couldn't corral it. And he got himself in perfect position. Deion Grant gets away from it. Now watch Sean Tu right here. He's in great position. And he gets both hands on the ball and just can't take care of the football.
Might have been some confusion with Herschel Bolden there.
That's like two outfielders trying to call it off. Who's going to make the catch?
Oh, the Tide. None of them can believe it. Coming up on the AXA Halftime Report, Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman bring you up to date on all the scores and highlights. It's all coming up on the AXA Halftime Report. So that would have worked out perfectly in the additional 5 yards. Had them in position to down it at the one. Zhao still looks a little bit wobbly as he tries to put weight on that right foot. They're going to cut the tape off.
Well, the right foot for a right-handed quarterback, that is his plant foot, Sean. And so, you know, if depending on how serious that is, that's a very difficult injury for a right-handed quarterback. As much as Alabama's been throwing, I mean, he's got to be able to plant on that right foot. We've got a quarterback limping around a little bit on the other side of the field, too.
T. Martin has not come back on the field.
Hmm.
and neither team has a proven backup. Joey Matthews is a redshirt freshman who has played behind T. Martin. There's Joey. He's appeared in three games, was attempted just one pass. That was in the last game against Georgia. And Tyler Watts, as you have seen, also a redshirt freshman playing behind Zhao.
Well, he's definitely going to come in because he's taking snaps, and the only thing, you know, T. Martin could have gotten hurt on was his touchdown run on the bootleg. It looks like his left knee that he's favoring. Let's take a look at the end of this play. As he goes across the goal line, there is contact. And right there, as he goes up in the air, he collides with Reggie Miles. And came up holding his left knee.
Here's Joey Matthews. The handoff to Jamal Lewis. Ordinarily, with almost a minute and a half to go, and timeouts at your disposal, Tennessee might play aggressively, but given that Martin's on the sideline, they might be content just to get into the locker room in a tie ball game and reevaluate T's status. Michelle Tafoya tells us that Andrew Zhao has a sprained right ankle, but they tell us they expect him to return, so perhaps they're optimistic after they ice it and he has the time at the half to get some treatment. Well,
the good news for both Zhao and Martin is that they're getting ready to go in the locker room, so they've got some extra time to heal without missing any action.
And second and six, the pitch to Lewis, and he's stacked up shy of the 25-yard line. Tuesday on CBS, America can handle the truth. JAG is the number one action drama. Find out what millions of people already know. Don't miss JAG Tuesday on CBS. Alabama has called a timeout with 22 seconds left in the half. They want to force a Tennessee punt in a 7-7 game. Remain that way in the second half with both quarterbacks banged up. Third down and six. Matthews is going to throw after the play action fake, and he's going deep, and it is incomplete. Hit the defender Milo Lewis in the back of the helmet. That ball just a little bit short for Cedric Wilson. He's gesturing to Matthews, hey, a little bit more and I had a touchdown.
Really a good call by Randy Sanders. Everybody in the building expecting Alabama to sit on the football and punt. They went with the out and up, the pump fake, and Joey Matthews just a little late getting that football up in the air, but a good call by Randy Sanders trying to make a big play at the end of the half.
He's in his first full year as offensive coordinator, been the running backs coach, took over for David Cutcliffe when he left to become the head coach at Ole Miss. The kicker is down, and there's a flag down, and Freddie Millins is knocked down across the 40 and out to midfield. Looked like Jason Jones hit David Leverton, who got off a 44-yard punt, the 16-yard return, but all of those stats may be wiped from the history books.
Well, what you wanted to do, the reason they used the timeouts was to force the punt to try to get in position to make a big play, but Jason Jones has to avoid that contact. You've got to aim for a spot where the ball is going to leave the foot, not at the man, and that time Jason Jones just a bad angle to the punter. And an unnecessary penalty, really, on Alabama.
Into the kicker, penalty against the defense. Repeat, fourth down.
It was fourth and six. It's a 5-yard penalty, so it'll be fourth and one. College football fans, get online and vote in the CBS Sports Line College Football Millennium Poll. This week's category is Team of the Century. The polls are open. Click on NCAA football at cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online. Enter keyword CBS Sports Line. With 2 seconds left, Tennessee uses a timeout. Ball's trying to decide what they want to do. They really don't have to punt. They could just probably have the punter run around for a little while and kill
time. They had their offense on the football field. Joey Matthews was on the field, as we see T. Martin going into the locker room to join his counterpart Andrew Zhao. But Joey Matthews is on the field, so they are going to probably just run a play and have the quarterback take the snap, and probably all he has to do is, you know, take a couple steps back and then take a knee. Mm-hmm. 2 seconds will run off. Why risk a long punt snap or trying to kick the football? Right. Just let your quarterback take it and take a few steps back and go to the ground. But he's got to, the biggest thing, he's got to make sure that he gets a good, clean exchange from the center. That's the first order of business for Joey Matthews.
Tennessee coaches told us Matthews has a good arm. But he's still learning. He's a good quarterback prospect. They have a true freshman, A.J. Sugg, who's one of the most highly recruited quarterbacks in the country last year out of Georgia, who they hope to redshirt this year. Matthews kills the time and ends the half. Alabama took the lead on a 26-yard touchdown pass out to Alexander. And Tennessee tied it on the 6-yard touchdown run by T. Martin. Here's Michelle.
All right, Coach, we're told T. Martin's injury is not serious, but it requires some further examination. If he can't go, how much does that change your game plan?
Well, obviously, it'll change some when you take your senior quarterback out, but we'll see how he is. I don't know right now. We'll just have to see.
What can and can you not do?
Joy can run our offense, basically, most of it. You know, we wouldn't do quite as much sprint out and that kind of thing. We hadn't done that today much anyway.
Tie ball game, how do you feel about your team's performance?
Fine. You knew it's going to be a four-quarter fight when you play Alabama any day.
Coach, thank you. Back to you, Sean.
Halftime in Tuscaloosa. Alabama and Tennessee tied at 7 a moment ago. Michelle spoke with Mike Dubose.
Coach, I'm told Andrew Zhao will return. Obviously, he sprained his ankle. How much will he be limited, if at all?
Well, I don't think he'll be limited at all right now, Michelle. We just have to see this first series. We got the football there, so we'll see. Tyler's got to be ready to go, but I think Andrew will be fine.
What are the biggest adjustments you had to make at halftime?
Well, we just have to execute better. We have some things there we feel like we just have to execute. You got to give Tennessee a lot of credit. They're playing hard, and they've given us some problems with some of their defensive adjustments. We have to just go and play and understand if they got 8 or 9 people in the line of scrimmage. If we can get past the line of scrimmage, we got a chance for a big play.
Coach, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Andrew Zhao sprained his right ankle late in the first half. He's taped up and seems ready to go.
Yeah, I think a big key for the rest of this ball game is which medical staff brought their A game to the stadium today, because you had both quarterbacks banged up in the first half. Both had to receive some attention, and neither team can afford to lose their starting quarterback, neither the Vols or the Crimson Tide.
David Leverton to kick off for Tennessee. Freddie Millins and Santonio Beard back deep, standing at the 5-yard line. Good kickoff with the win by Leverton. About 8 yards deep in the end zone, Millins takes an E. 7-7, a defensive battle halftime. Todd, these two teams, Tennessee struggling a little bit on offense coming into this game. And Alabama with problems on defense. If you're a Bama fan, you probably think, gee, our defense is a lot better.
Right.
If you're a Tennessee fan, you're probably saying our offense still isn't very good.
Well, Alabama, the 12th ranked defense, they held Tennessee to an average of 3.3 yards per play in that first half. So they really played better than we've seen over the last couple weeks. I think a big key right now, Sean, no turnovers in that first half. Whichever one of these defenses that can force a turnover is going to be very important.
It's Tyler Watts, a quarterback. So despite what Coach DeBose just said to Michelle, Zhao does not begin the half. And it's Alexander on the rush for 4 to the 24. And it'll be second down and 6. 61 yards rushing now for Sean Alexander on 13 carries. Tyler Watts, redshirt freshman from Pelham, Alabama. He threw for nearly 2,500 yards and 20 touchdowns as a senior in high school for the Pelham Panthers, and was the Alabama State Class 6A Player of the Year. Movement and contact and whistles and flags. Not only a turnover-free first half, but relatively flag-free first half as well. 6 penalties combined. T. Martin just came out of the locker room. He's trying to get loose on the sideline. And Michelle has an update on his situation.
Well, it is a left hamstring injury, guys. They were icing it, and they put a sleeve on it to protect and just sort of support that hamstring. They're going to see what he can do here on the sidelines before they try to put him in the game. But his return at this point is questionable. Back to you.
He's on the bike. Darwin Walker and Radock Thompson jumped offside. Second down and a short one. Looked like movement over the ball again. Dustin McClintock driven back. Short of the first down. Sean Ellis with some penetration. And we take a look at the halftime stats. Alabama last in the league defensively, giving up 354 yards per game, allowed just 102 to Tennessee in the first half.
Tennessee, we knew they could play good defense coming into the football game. And if you think they were flying up the field and going after the quarterback in the first half, if Andrews out doesn't come back in, they're going to really turn it up a notch, because they don't think Watts is near the threat as a runner that Andrews out was.
And they are right about that. Now it's Alexander following the fullback. McClintock needed to get the ball right to the 30-yard line. Raynock Thompson made the stop. Any part of that ball's on the yard marker, it's going to be a first down.
You know, this doesn't look like much, this run. I mean, it's third and less than one, but that is a big run for Sean Alexander. You've got a backup quarterback in. Tennessee trying to stop you on short yardage, and he just kind of slithers and slides and slips his way towards that first down marker. It's a 1 yard run. That's what it'll go down in the books as, but it could be a very, very important first down for Alabama.
So the all purpose yards today for Alexander. He averages 206 all purpose yards per game. That's number one in the nation. Well, they didn't quite get the ball according to the spot to the 30-yard line.
Got to punt the football.
Yes. And Patrick Morgan will. So they had second down and inches. And on two tries, couldn't get the inches.
Sean, Tennessee's defense is so incredibly fast. I mean, this is the fastest defense that I've seen in a long time. They really can run to the football. I mean, something might open up, but it doesn't stay open very long against this bunch.
Patrick Morgan to punt for the fourth time. Eric Parker back at his 37. Morgan kicking into the breeze. It's died down a bit, but still not a very good punt. Down at the 43-yard line by Victor Ellis. 28 yards on the punt by Morgan. Now it's time for the Applebee's traditions of the game. And earlier today, the University of Alabama and the fans here paid tribute to one of the great linemen in football history, John Hanna, considered by many the greatest offensive lineman ever.
Member of the National Football Foundation and College Football Hall of Fame, John Hanna.
He will officially go into the College Football Hall of Fame in December. Unanimous All-American in 1972. Went on to an NFL Hall of Fame career with the Patriots. Jamal Lewis out to the 44-yard line. What a great player John Hanna was. 17 Alabama products now in the College Football Foundation Hall of Fame. And John now a very successful businessman in the Boston area.
You know, the folks at Alabama like to think that they had the best offensive guard that ever played in John Hanna, the best center in Dwight Stevenson that ever played, and they're thinking Chris Samuels may eventually be considered one of the best tackles that's ever played.
But T. Martin in at quarterback, Lewis gain one. Here comes the blitz, and they get Martin. That was timed perfectly. Miguel Merritt across the line of scrimmage. The Tennessee sideline thought he was across the line too quickly.
Well, it's awful close, but again, this has to fall on T. Martin. I mean, he's got to do something different with his snap count. You can't let that guy time that and hit it on the fly. The offensive line has no chance to make that play. The problem when you have motion, you're limited into what you can do with your snap count. You have to keep the timing of the motion, and that time Miguel Merritt hit it on the fly.
Third sack for the Bama defense. Third down and 12. They show a three-man rush. Lewis runs through the defense. First down, Tennessee. Down to the 43 of Alabama. Marcus Spencer made the tackle. That's a 16-yard run for Jamal Lewis.
We talked about Sean Alexander. You better bring your good tackling to the field. You better do that against this guy, too. Cornelius Griffin was in position 97, couldn't wrap him up. And then Jamal Lewis shows a little burst to the outside. A big run by Jamal Lewis. Your quarterback's banged up. It's third down. Give it to 31 and let him make a play.
They fake it to 31. Martin going for the deep ball, and it is caught! Touchdown, Tennessee! David Martin!
Picked on the true freshman, Sean. It was Gerald Dixon, a guy that Ellis Johnson and the defensive coaches are extremely high on. They think he's going to be an outstanding corner. But this time, he gets beat off the ball. And when he turns to find the ball, that's where the separation comes from David Martin. When Dixon turned to find the football, Martin separated to the football.
Alex Walls adds the extra point. David Martin with his first career touchdown. A 43-yard strike from T. Martin. They are not related, but they have combined to give Tennessee its first lead. David Leverton. After the Tennessee touchdown, which was set up by another short Alabama punt. Good kickoff by Leverton, and Millen's downed it.
Let's go back to the touchdown. On the pre-snap, T. Martin saw he had single coverage, but after the ball is snapped, he saw the safeties bite on the play fake, and that told him there's going to be no help over the top. One-on-one coverage, just lay it out there and let Martin try to make a play. On the pre-snap, he saw man-to-man. On the post-snap, he saw he's got no help over the top. Good read by T. Martin and a good job of getting the football out there and letting his guy go get it.
David Martin beat Gerald Dixon, the true freshman, for the touchdown. Tyler Watts still the quarterback, so Andrew Zhao has not returned. Since halftime, Watts, bad pass, a little high, catchable for Alexander. But he didn't take it in, and it might be just as well for Bama with the defense coming hard. Here's Michelle.
Well, guys, it was Andrew Zhao's decision not to start the second half, but now he does appear ready to come back in. That's his decision as well. He told the trainers, look, I can go, but tell the offensive coaches, do not be conservative with me if I return. Back up to you.
Well, I think Alabama, this is going to be a critical decision for them to make about where to go, because they can't be conservative with Tyler Watts either. And while Watts is in there, the biggest concern I have about him, he has to get a feel for the speed of this game. He can't hold the ball very long against this Tennessee defense.
And evidence there is he got buried trying to set up the quick hitter to Antonio Carter. John Henderson welcomed Watts into the ball game.
Tennessee all over that wide receiver screen this time. They get the great penetration up the field on the inside. The linemen in a hurry to get out and try to set up the screen. Maybe left a little too soon as Henderson got a good shot on the quarterback, but it wasn't open out there either. Tennessee waiting for that play on that particular second down.
Henderson doing a nice job filling in for Billy Ratliff, gone for the year with the broken leg. Third down and 10. Alexander comes out to the left, setting up another middle screen. Terry Jones Jr., the tight end, chopped down short of the first down at the 25 by Fred White.
A whole lot of trickery on that play, Sean. Sean Alexander came out like he was going to play quarterback and then ran out to a wide receiver, seeing if Tennessee would forget about him. And then they tried to slip the tight end, but a nice open field tackle by Fred White. We've seen him make a couple plays like that in the open field.
Well, Bama looking for a better punt for Morgan. Old Tennessee touchdown drive set up by short Morgan punts, and here's another. Bounce near midfield. And Morgan starting to hear the boos. That's a 29-yard punt out of bounds at the 45. Tennessee leads by a touchdown, and the Vols will have it after this. Welcome back to Tuscaloosa. T. Martin and the Volunteers have a 7-point lead. Still early in the third quarter. First and 10 balls on their own 46. Jamal Lewis, a hard-earned yard. Kenny Smith made the first hit. Salim Rashid helped finish Lewis off. Tomorrow on the NFL Today, join Jim, Craig, Randy, and Jerry for all the latest NFL news. Plus, Marcus Allen looks at the high-flying St. Louis Rams offense led by Kurt Warner. Craig James visits the miracle man of the Buffalo Bills, Doug Flutie. That's all coming up at noon Eastern on the NFL Today. And then for all the scores and highlights, stay with the gentleman for the NASDAQ halftime report. Second and 9. Martin pursued, but escapes and slides down in front of Miguel Merritt at the 49-yard line. Looked like he was going to get buried for a loss. And no sign of any hamstring problem as he escaped the difficulty behind the line.
No, it looked pretty good moving there. And Sean, I'll tell you who is due to make a play for Tennessee right now is Cedric Wilson.
Yep.
He had one catch for 4 yards in the first half, and he has been their primary threat in the passing game. He's been very quiet today.
He leads the SEC in 109 receiving yards per game, but 4 yards on one catch today. They show blitz. They bring the blitz. Lewis trying to run through it and cannot. Marcus Spencer dropped him for a loss.
That's a great defensive series for Alabama, Sean, because 2 touchdown drives of Tennessee. One was 60 yards, one was 43 yards. The result of poor punting. Another poor punt gave Tennessee good field position, but 3 and out for the Alabama defense, and Marcus Spencer right there to corral Jamal Lewis. Good defense by Alabama on that turnaround.
And a nice play by Spencer, who was taken out of the starting lineup last week. Lost his starting job at safety. Reggie Miles was moved inside. Leverton, wow, what a punt that is. High and booming, and into the end zone. 53 yards on the punt by Leverton. Still 14-7. Tennessee with the lead in the third quarter in Tuscaloosa. The big Dame, the big day for the big Ron Dame, the Heisman Trophy candidate. And Sean Alexander trying to put together another 100-yard rushing day. He has 62 yards rushing. Andrew Zhao in for the first time of the second half. At quarterback, on this the third possession of the half for Alabama. They did not pick up a first down with Tyler Watts at quarterback. Raynock Thompson made the stop on Sean Alexander. A pickup of 2, 15 carries, 64 yards rushing for Sean. 4 receptions, 45 yards receiving, and a touchdown for Alexander. Trying to take advantage of this national exposure again today to enhance his Heisman chances.
And playing against the best defense that he's faced. This is a, you know, this defense is legit. Sometimes you look at statistics and they don't tell the whole story, but this team, their numbers don't lie. They can run. And I think the onus right now is on the Alabama offensive line. You've got a quarterback that's a little gimpy. They got to do a better job.
They flip it to Freddie Millins, looking for a lead block, a block from Chris Samuels. And the play yielded just 1 yard. Darwin Walker forced him out. Well, it's a lot of the same people, Todd, that were part of the national championship defense for Tennessee last year. And they were incredibly fast last year. They haven't gotten any slower. Speed all over the field on this Tennessee defense, ranked number 3 in the nation against the rush coming in. Mike Dubose said he thinks Tennessee is the most talented team overall in the country.
The big question about this defense, would there be a void in leadership with losing Al Wilson, but they've had several guys that have stepped up and provided leadership.
Still have not allowed a rushing touchdown this season. There's a first down. Zhao to Freddie Millins. Out to the 36. Mickey Allen comes in the nickel and dime situations, made the tackle after a gain of 13.
Sean, Andrew Zhao, he's not 100%. He's going to grit it out and go. And that's, again, why there's so much now more burden on the offensive line, because Andrew Zhao is not going to elude many people here the rest of this ball game. He's going to try to play. And if he can set his feet and make the throws, he's going to be okay. But if he has to try to move around, he's going to have some problems. And that time, good protection allowed him to get the ball to Millins downfield.
He had a torn left ACL in high school. Had some teams recruiting him back away as he was heading into his senior year. Did not play his entire senior year. Got into only 4 games. Alexander pulled down by D'Angelo Lloyd, a reserve defensive end. That's a gain of 7. It'll be 2nd down and 3. Alabama hoping to drive for the tying touchdown. And Zhao on television doesn't look like he's 6'2", 221 pounds. I would say in person yesterday, I'm not sure about the 6'2", but he's every bit of 220 pounds, as he told us yesterday.
Well, he had on baggy shorts when we met with him yesterday, but when you see him in football pants, he's got some big, thick legs. He's got a strong lower body, compact guy.
Andrew, the youngest of 8 children, he lost it as he turned a pitch, or fake a pitch, perhaps. And Raynock Thompson and Sean Ellis were right there. Zhao had to pounce on it very quickly. And the Tennessee defender slow to get up. Raynock Thompson, he waved the medical staff away, but they did stop the action, so he'll have to come out.
You can see the guard got the football. Will Cuthbert was pulling on that play, and Andrew Zhao just didn't get the ball into his body quick enough, and the ball hit his guard, Will Cuthbert, and came out. Good job by Zhao falling on the football, but kind of a critical play. 2nd down and 3, you know, you're in good position. Now you've got a 3rd and 5, a little different, a little tougher situation against this Tennessee defense. sometimes, you know, if you're hurting like Andrew Zhao, you're thinking about your ankle, you're thinking about not getting it hurt any worse, and maybe you lose your concentration on a couple other little things. That time he didn't protect the football.
On third and five, Zhao throws a wobbler, almost intercepted. Andre Lott closest to it. Pass was intended for Jason McCadley. Mickey Allen came on a safety blitz and got in the face of Zhao.
Man-to-man coverage, the blitz came untouched, Mickey Allen, and Zhao lucky this one wasn't picked off because he didn't get nearly enough on the football.
Ball was prevails of Patrick Morgan. He's had a 30-yard punt, a 28-yard punt, and another 30-yard punt today. This isn't good. Fair catch made by Eric Parker. That's a 27-yard punt.
And you can see just in his body language, I mean, he is not feeling very good confidence-wise right now. And then once that happens to a kicker, it's pretty tough to get him out of that.
Mike DuBose is going to have a chat with him now.
Yeah. I mean, he needs him. I mean, he's got nowhere else to go right now. You don't want to make that switch because Morgan has punted well. But, boy, that's a fragile psyche when you're dealing with kickers.
He's averaging 41 yards per punt for the season. Coming in, his backup is Lane Bearden, who handles the kickoffs, but who has not punted in a game situation this year. First and 10. T. Martin for the far sideline, broken up. Intended for Cedric Wilson, Kelp Bailey. Broke it up. Nice play by Bailey, the Tuscaloosa native.
If you want to try to get Cedric Wilson involved in the ball game, he's been a big player for you all season. Kelp Bailey got away with a little hold there and then got in position to make the play. The ball was a little bit thrown behind Wilson, and that enabled Bailey to make a play.
Wilson still with just one catch today. He's had at least 6 receptions in every game this season. Higher 2 today. Came in with 2 straight games of 100 yards receiving or more. Travis Henry in at the tailback position. There's a catch for Wilson. Out of bounds with a first down at the 45-yard line.
Great block by Eric Parker, the other wide receiver, on linebacker Miguel Merritt. Just did a great job of sealing this off right here. You throw the wide receiver screen, you got to get your other receivers out there getting a block. David Martin got a little bit of a block on Dixon, enough to get Wilson to the first down, but two receivers getting good blocks downfield.
Here's Travis Henry across midfield and down at the 48-yard line. Gerald Dixon upended Henry.
Take a look again at a wide receiver, David Martin, much bigger physically than Gerald Dixon. Dixon still makes the tackle, but not until the ball was well down the field.
Second and 3, under 5 minutes left in the third quarter. Tennessee leads 14-7. They trailed 7-0. It was 7-7 at the half. A rare carry for the fullback, Philip Crosby, carrying for just the 4th time this season. And a short gain, he did not pick up the first down. 1 week from Monday, there's a whole new choice in the morning. Ryan Gumbel returns to morning television with Jane Clayson on The Early Show, premiering 1 week from Monday, right here on CBS. Third down and 2.
Got to watch for the little reverse with Ontario Smith, who's in the ball game, number 25 for Tennessee.
He was the motion man. Martin zips one, and it is incomplete. Looking for Smith. Milo Lewis in tight coverage. And a decision for Philip Fulmer. On 4th down and 2 at the 47 of Alabama, and he's going to punt and rely on that terrific defense.
Use field position. Smith, a very talented freshman out of Sacramento, California, and he just kind of runs right into Milo Lewis. Milo Lewis had a right to be there, and Ontario Smith, the young player, didn't give himself any room.
There's Leverton punting to Millens. Aiming for the corner. Contrast to Morgan, Leverton's had a terrific day punting, but that one skipped into the end zone. He was hoping for a different type of bounce. 47 yards on the kick, but just a net of 27. Now we have another Home Depot college football doubleheader for you next Saturday, beginning at noon Eastern time. The West Virginia Mountaineers take on number 23 Miami. Boy, did the Hurricanes survive a scare day. Boston College coming from 28-0 down to defeat the Eagles on a last-second field goal. And we'll be in Jacksonville for the annual battle between Florida and Georgia. We'll hear from Tim and Spencer, the AXA halftime report in each game. Three receivers to the right. Now the tight end Jones in motion to left. Alexander burst through. Sean Alexander out to the 37-yard line. A 17-yard run for Sean. Deion Grant had to pull him down from behind.
That's exactly what Mike Dubose talked about at halftime. If they're going to put that many people on the line of scrimmage, if we can get through that line of scrimmage, we can make a big play. See, he's got a nice opening there. He's got the vision. He gets through that initial line of scrimmage and turns it into a big run.
88 yards rushing now for Alexander on 18 carries. Now 624 career rushes for Alexander. He's moved past Bobby Humphrey, has carried it more than anybody in Bama history. The pump fake, the long ball incomplete. Freddie Millins was open, but the pass off target with Deion Grant providing the volunteer coverage.
They got a great matchup there, and Andrew Zhao is going to wish he had this one back because they put Millins in motion, and that drew coverage from the safeties. Deion Grant, who's not used to being in man coverage, he's used to being a free safety. And as good a player as he is, Millins ran right by him because he's not used to being out there as a corner. They got the matchup they wanted. Andrew Zhao just couldn't make the completion or the throw.
Five receptions today for Millins. He's on the sideline catching his breath. Alexander faked the handoff to Antonio Carter. First down, it would appear, for Alabama out near the 47. He needed to get just across the 46. It might require a measurement. Darwin Walker.
Sean, he is so good.
To Carter.
He is so good. I mean, this play doesn't look like it should gain anything. It looks like it's going to be stopped in the backfield. And again, you see the broken tackles. I mean, these are strong. Darwin Walker's the strongest guy in the Tennessee team and couldn't bring him down. Again, yards after contact. You have to tackle with good fundamentals when you play Sean Alexander. He's more powerful than he appears. 214 pounds. And he's very slippery. He doesn't give you a clean shot at him when he runs. He turns his hips and shoulders really well.
Well, we heard him talk earlier during our Mentors of the Game segment about his dad and his brother Duran. There's Duran, the Notre Dame graduate, now working as an executive for a prominent soup company. Former drummer in the Notre Dame marching band. He's here regularly. He and his brother Sean very, very close. Play clock at one. Zhao wanted a timeout. Did he get it in time? Yes. It's the first timeout used by either team here in the second half. 2.5 left in the third quarter. Mike Dubose and the Tide down by 7. John McDonough, Michelle Tafoya, Todd Blackledge. 2.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Here in Tuscaloosa, 1st and 10, Alabama. From its own 46. After the timeout, the handoff and the delay. Sean Alexander. No gain on the play. Wrapped up by Dominique Stevenson, junior from Gaffney, South Carolina, who has taken over at middle linebacker for Al Wilson, who's gone to the NFL. And he didn't move the middle linebacker until 3 days had passed to spring practice. So he's learning the new position as he goes. He was a tailback in high school, but when he arrived here, they had Jamal Lewis, Travis Stevens, Travis Henry. They didn't need him to be a running back.
He banged up his knee in the Georgia game also, and maybe not quite 100%, but looks pretty good today.
Out of the shotgun. Blitz. Zhao throws, almost intercepted by Mickey Allen. He stepped in front of Millins. Ad Golden, a reserve defensive back, came in to put the heat on Zhao and almost got a hand on Zhao as he was throwing.
Little pressure on the blitz and the ball thrown behind Millens. Mickey Allen got away with a little bit of a grab, but the ball thrown well behind Millens, and that's why Mickey Allen was able to make the play.
The officials have been pretty consistent today in allowing that. They've allowed some clutching and grabbing downfield on both sides.
Alabama needs to speed up. Their play clock under 10 again. They've already burned one timeout because of this.
Play clock at 2. Zhao takes the snap, but ahead of hurry on a crucial play. Alexander dropped the ball. In all likelihood, that was a touchdown.
Yes, sirree.
He got away from Fred White, who had the coverage, and he had all kinds of empty space ahead of him.
The key when you spread them out is to find the best matchups, and they had the matchup. Sean Alexander going against Fred White. Here they are right here. That's a mismatch in favor of Alabama. But Alexander just can't come up with the catch. He's made most of those catches. Couldn't grab that one.
Morgan to punt. The deep man's only 30 yards off the line of scrimmage. This is a better kick. It drives Parker back inside the 20. And he's taken down to the 22-yard line. A 37-yard punt, the 5-yard return by Parker. Time now for our Rigid Tool Scholar Athlete Award. Our Scholar Athlete of the Game, Tennessee starting offensive tackle Josh Tucker. 3.34 grade point average in mechanical engineering. Rigid Tool's commitment to the investment of our future shown today by donating $1,000 to the University of Tennessee's General Scholarship Fund. Josh Tucker, senior from Asheville, North Carolina, lost his left eye to a tumor at age 3. And he hasn't let it slow him down at all. He says, I'm used to it. Jamal Lewis, the ball carrier for very little. Darius Gilbert made the tackle. T. Martin, 17-1 as a starting quarterback in college. The only loss earlier this year at Florida. Lewis again out to the 25. We're under a minute left in the third quarter. Largest crowd ever to see a football game in the state of Alabama. More than 86,000 on hand watching this top 10 matchup. Tennessee ranked number 5, Alabama number 10. Tennessee leads by a touchdown. They fell behind 7-0 in the second quarter, but T. Martin scored on a 6-yard run. Then he threw a touchdown pass here in the third quarter to David Martin to give the Balls the lead. Martin on third down, batted down by Darius Gilbert.
Sean, Alabama has been a lot more aggressive today in blitzing in the third down passing situations, and they're blitzing up inside trying to get right into the face of T. Martin. They know that he's most dangerous pulling it down and running up the middle. They're negating that, and they're getting pressure on him and making him throw when he doesn't want to.
Leverton to punt. 10 men up on the line. They come after it, and they didn't get it. Millens from the 34. Dancing back to the 34. Well, no yardage on the return after a 41-yard boot by Leverton. And a long snapper, Kevin Gregory, made the tackle. That's the end of the third quarter with the score Tennessee 14 and Alabama 7. We'll return to Bryant-Denny Stadium right after this message and a word from your local station. Well, it's a great rivalry. We have a tremendous scene here at Bryant-Denny Stadium. First and 10, Alabama. First play of the fourth quarter. Tennessee leads by a touchdown. Bama begins at its own 34. Sean Alexander for a yard. Todd, what do you look for here in the fourth quarter?
Well, I'll tell you what, Alabama's got to make some plays throwing the football because Tennessee is really ganging up on Sean Alexander, ganging up on the running game, and it's interesting. You know, we've seen this team 3 weeks before this, and that play to Millens in the last series, it was overthrown, and the play to Alexander on third down that was right off the fingertips. The last 3 weeks, this team has made those plays. So far, they haven't been able to make those plays today, and therefore they're behind by a touchdown.
There you go, the triple stack, three receivers to the right. Zhao going deep and off target. Looking for Antonio Carter and Andre Lott had the coverage. There was no scoring in the first quarter. The second quarter began on a 26-yard touchdown pass, Zhao to Alexander. And later in the second quarter, T. Martin took it in himself and injured his leg on that play, a 6-yard touchdown run. And early in the third, David Martin, a 43-yard touchdown pass from T. Martin. Both Tennessee touchdowns set up by short Alabama punts. This Alabama offense had rolled up 400 yards or more of total offense in each of the last three games. First time they've done that three games in a row since 1993. Today held a 204 yards by this terrific Tennessee defense. Zhao's pass batted down by Eric Westmoreland.
Great play by Eric Westmoreland. I made the comment earlier that he gives you a lot of luxury because he's a linebacker, so he's physical, but he's also quick enough to cover a guy like Sean Alexander out of the backfield. I mean, he's right there on Sean Alexander, gets his hand on the football, a very versatile defender for Tennessee.
Dow is 1 for 7 passing this half, after going 10 for 14 in the first half. Well, Morgan has the wind at his back now, and that helps. Parker went back to the 15. He retreats back to the 15 and gets belted down. Herschel Bolden had help from Jeremy Walker. A 51-yard punt and a return of 1 yard. 14 minutes left in Tuscaloosa. Well, defensive coordinator Ellis Johnson's unit has done its job, having held Tennessee to just 183 yards of offense. But the Vols lead by 7. Here's Jamal Lewis. Trying to bounce it outside. Delivers the stiff arm. What a tough run for a short game. Finally, Milo Lewis and Marvin Constant able to corral them, but it looked like it would be no gain or a loss. Instead, it's a pickup out near the 19.
Well, anytime you can get a back going this way along the line of scrimmage, he's not going to hurt you very much. I don't care how powerful he is. If he can't get his shoulders turned upfield, he becomes very average. And that time, Alabama did a great job of stringing Lewis out and forcing him to the sideline. As you take a look at the two backs in the ball game today, Alexander, a little better day.
Lewis needs 3 more yards to move into the top 5 in Tennessee rushing history and pass Reggie Cobb. The ball dangerously juggled by Wilson, and he's thrown for a loss by Reggie Miles. When that ball went up in the air, every Volunteer fan had to hold his or her breath.
You know, and he almost would have been better off batting it down once he didn't catch it cleanly. As long as it was a forward pass, now he knows he's going to lose yardage once he regains control. And a good play by Reggie Miles coming up from his free safety spot. Now, you can't say enough about this Alabama defense. Tennessee thought they had turned the corner on offense in the Georgia game, 458 yards against the Bulldogs. But they have found nothing comes easy today against Ellis Johnson's defense.
On 3rd and 14, Martin is going to try to run for it. First down, Tennessee. One of the biggest concerns Ellis Johnson had coming into the ball game is what he just saw. T. Martin in a long yarded situation, tucking it under and running for a crucial play. That's 15 yards on 3rd down and 14.
When he sees the middle of the field open up, he is very good at just tucking it and going. I mean, when he sees those linebackers get out of there and he knows he's got an opening right here, he is very fast and very powerful, and he's not afraid to run it up in there. Big first down.
Out to the 27. Lewis the lone back. 4 receivers spread the field. Lewis Bouncing to the 31, where Kenny King tripped him up.
That's just such a good play by T. Martin. You know, he's such a warrior. He's playing hurt again today. He knows his team is struggling offensively. He's got to find a way to make a play. Not huge numbers, but boy, was that a huge run on third down.
With that run, Jamal Lewis has moved past Reggie Cobb into the top five in career rushing yards at the University of Tennessee. Short drop by Martin. The completion made, and Cedric Wilson has the first down. He had the first down when he caught the ball, actually gave it up for a moment by circling back, but then advanced far enough to move the chains, tackled by Cornelius Griffin and Gerald Dixon. It's been a relatively quiet day for Cedric Wilson, although it's starting to pick up. He came into today's game on pace to set the single season records at Tennessee for receptions and receiving yardage. Both records established by Marcus Nash in 1997. Wilson was a high school quarterback in Memphis at Melrose High. Saleem Rashid, Cornelius Griffin pulled down Lewis. For Cedric Wilson, as a quarterback at Memphis Melrose, he passed for more than 6,500 yards and 104 touchdowns as a three-year starter. And as a senior, he threw for 2,900 yards and 41 touchdowns and also rushed for 579 yards. Kendall Moorhead, the Alabama defensive end, one of his teammates on that squad.
Andre Lott, starting cornerback. Another guy on the Tennessee roster, Kevin Taylor. Four of them playing major college football. No wonder they won the state championship in 1996.
Right now, the biggest play of the game was that conversion on third and 14 on T. Martin's 15-yard run. Flags down, moving along the line. There are all the players from Melrose High School in Memphis. Todd just mentioned offside against Alabama. Looked like Kenny Smith was the man doing the encroaching. That'll make it very close to a first down. Gonna be second down in less than a yard. And the officials wind the clock, so it'll go under 10 and a half remaining. Alabama with two timeouts left. Tennessee with all three. Possession started at the Volunteers 16-yard line. Lewis trying to get outside. Delivers the stiff arm again. Picks up the first down. Reggie Miles finally able to pull him down. Jamal Lewis moves Tennessee into Alabama territory with the first down.
Reggie Miles got up limping on that tackle. Looked like he turned on his ankle a little bit. Remember, he's the guy that moved from cornerback to free safety 2 weeks ago. Marcus Spencer, who was the starting strong safety, was demoted. Now Spencer will be back in as the strong safety, and Tony Dixon will move back to free safety.
Tennessee's taken more than 4 minutes off the clock with this drive. Inside handoff to Lewis. And a short game to the 45. Kendall Moorhead and Chris Horn combined on the play. Sunday on 60 Minutes. Now a late flag comes down. We'll tell you about it in a moment. Ed Bradley and Bill Bradley on why he wants to be president. Bill, that is, not Ed. 60 Minutes Sunday. Maybe Ed wants to be president too. But Bill's going to talk about why he wants to be president. There's a very late flag thrown. It's going against Tennessee.
After the play is over, personal foul against the offense, 15 yards, third down.
Well, there are costly penalties, and then there are costly penalties. And this one could be a huge one against the Volunteers. They've got momentum. They have a nice drive going. They're killing the clock. They've got the lead. A very costly penalty on the Volunteers.
And moves them back to their own 40. And it is second down. They need to reach the Alabama 37 for a first down. They lean heavily on the run today. They set up the wide receiver screen to Cedric Wilson. Good call. He might go. out of bounds. The last man with a chance was Tony Dixon, who took the angle and brought him down at the 23-yard line, a gain of 36.
Well, Wilson will get his name in the paper in the glory, but Josh Tucker, number 77, got the key block. Watch as Wilson separates from Dixon. Tucker gets a piece of Dixon, and that allows Wilson to get straight up the field. Good blocking downfield. Cedric Wilson made a nice play, but Josh Tucker, the tackle, coming out there, got the block on Dixon to free him.
Travis Henry in a tailback. First and 10. And now we're in field goal range. A little kicking game, still a question. Henry, a gain of one before Marvin Constant and Cornelius Griffin sent him back. They're on their second kicker of the season. Alex Walls took over after Robert Loudermilk was injured with a back problem early in the season. And Walls is unproven. Maybe a kick into the wind. They'd much prefer just punching it in the end zone, as you would anyway, but particularly under these circumstances.
Well, and Philip Fulmer feels pretty good with Walls from 25 yards and in. Anything further than that, he's got a little problem. Maybe even goes to Leverton for that kick.
Big plays on this drive. The third down conversion by T. Martin. The pass play to Wilson. Here's Martin inside the 10, inside the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. The kind of drive you see from a championship team.
Sean, and when the running game gets going this way, watch the Alabama defense follow the fake to the running back. Salim Rashid, a freshman, gets fooled by the fake, and then T. Martin, bad hamstring and all, shows you the speed to get to the end zone.
Walls adds the extra point. T. Martin's second rushing touchdown of the afternoon. He threw for the other. This one a 21-yard scamper. And the lead is 21-7, Tennessee with 8:26 left. An impressive drive by Tennessee, 84 yards in 11 plays, 5 minutes and 35 seconds. Some big plays on the drive. Now a big kickoff by Leverton through the hands of Santonio Beard and out of the back of the end zone. And Alabama will begin at its 20. Tonight on CBS, Samo becomes the target of a ruthless embezzler after $6 million inexplicably appears in his bank account. On an all-new Martial Law tonight on CBS.
The Alabama offense has to answer right here, Sean. 8:23 left. The Tennessee offense, what a drive that was, converting that second and 23.
And getting in the third and 14.
Yeah.
Zhao out of the spread, off target. Shamari Buchanan, whether it's the ankle or not, we do not know, but he has been way off target here in the second half after a 10 for 14 first half.
I think the ankle is bothering him. I mean, again, it's his plant foot, and he's obviously not feeling 100% comfortable setting that foot and stepping into the throw. He's been behind on most of his throws. He's not getting them out in front of his receivers. It's not really affecting the zip that he has on the ball, but his accuracy has certainly been affected.
1 for 8 in the second half for 13 yards. Andrew Zhao. They stay with the spread. Sean Alexander is still shy of 100 yards rushing by 2 yards. Zhao hit as he throws, incomplete. Looking for Terry Jones Jr. Tad Golden. The defensive back came on the blitz again and again made contact with Zhao.
They had a chance here with slipping the tight end out, but it was just good, quick pressure. Again, the speed of this Tennessee defense coming on the blitz forces Zhao to get rid of it. A bad throw before he could find his tight end, Jones, getting open.
8 incompletions in a row now for Zhao. Martin, playing with a leg injury, has had a good second half. 3rd and 10. They blitz again. Shamari Buchanan made the catch. The defender fell down. And it's a first down for Bama. Down to the 40. Andre Locke got back on his feet to make the tackle. And that's a 20-yard gain for Buchanan, the senior from Atlanta. He was a high school teammate of Jamal Lewis at Douglas in Atlanta.
A huge conversion for Alabama. You know, with a two-touchdown lead, Tennessee doesn't have to think run very much. They know they can just go after Andrew Zhao, and that time Buchanan able to get some separation from Lott. Lott did fall down, but a huge conversion for the Crimson Tide.
Under 8 minutes left, two timeouts left for Alabama. Zhao throws over the middle, inaccurately again for Jason McCadley. Mickey Allen was running alongside McCadley. Now sprained his right ankle late in the first half and left for a while. For those of you who just joined us, it appeared he injured it on this play. Stayed in for another play or two before departing.
Now this was the play that aggravated it or re-aggravated it, and he had to leave. And Tyler Watts came in for a couple series, but Andrew Zhao trying to make a go of it here, but certainly not the same Andrew Zhao that we've seen for 3 weeks. And some of that credit goes to Tennessee. This is the first defense that has really put pressure on him as well.
Zhao lofts it out for Alexander. Needed all of his skills to turn that into a game for the 43, where Dwayne Goodrich pulled him down. Tennessee has won 15 straight games against teams from the SEC West. The last time they lost to a West Division team, 1994, when Alabama posted its most recent victory over Tennessee. The ball is trying to make it 5 in a row over the Tide for the first time ever in a rivalry that dates back to 1901. They've had stretches where they've had 6 years in a row when they were unbeaten against Bama, but never 5 straight wins. Terrible pass by Zhao. Antonio Carter was wide open, and the ball went over his head. On 4th down and 7, Mike DuBose with 7 minutes left will punt.
Yeah, here's Antonio Carter, and you're right, Sean. He gets right into the middle of the field, and he is wide open. It's a zone defense this time by Tennessee. They all went to Sean Alexander, and that left Carter wide open there, and Zhao just couldn't make the throw.
9th punt for Patrick Morgan. They're looking for a possible fake. Fair catch called for and made by Eric Parker at the 18, a 39-yard kick by Morgan. 6:52 left. Tennessee back on offense with a 14-point lead. There's John Chavis, the defensive coordinator for Tennessee, deservedly getting more and more recognition for his outstanding abilities with the performance of this Tennessee defense in recent years. They've been terrific today. Jamal Lewis, burst of speed. Finally forced out of bounds by Reggie Miles.
As good as the Alabama defense played all day here in the last couple series, in the last 10 minutes of the game, they've had some letdowns. We saw it on the last series, giving up a couple long conversions, and then a little complacent on this play. And Jamal Lewis gets this time, he gets his shoulders turned upfield. Good blocking on the right side, a couple missed tackles, and then the speed of Jamal Lewis.
And that puts him over 100 yards rushing now in a 43-yard game. Second 100-yard rushing game of the season, his first since the opener against Wyoming when he went for 159. Here he comes left. Hurdling a would-be tackler Merritt. Cornelius Griffin banged him down. At the 35-yard line, the clock runs under 6.5 minutes left, and it's time for our CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Talked about the Tennessee defense that has not allowed an opposing rusher to gain 100 yards this season. As a matter of fact, they haven't done it since the meeting against Alabama last year when Sean Alexander went for 132. Sean is 98 today. Didn't have any carries on their last possession because they threw the ball on every down. Complete college football coverage. Go to cbs.sportsline.com. 2nd and 5. Travis Henry now in a tailback. Lewis gets a breather. Henry cuts inside. And it looks like this Tennessee offense is finally starting to get in a little bit of a rhythm. Jason Jones made the stop very close to another first down.
Offensive line starting to take control of things up front. And, you know, Sean, we talked about during the last break when Alabama played Florida. Florida came in and said, we're not going to let Alabama beat us running the football. We're not going to let Sean Alexander beat us. We're going to have to put it in Zal's hands. But they laid back and played zone, and Zal beat him. Tennessee says, we're not going to let Alexander beat us either, but we're going to blitz Andrew Zal. So far, it's worked.
Timeout called by Alabama. Just one timeout left now for Alabama with 5:48 remaining. Rejection starting to show on the face of Sean Alexander. With his team down by 14. First and 10. Martin with a safe pass. Philip Crosby, the fullback, down near the 21-yard line. Let's get an update on the Mississippi State ball game from Tim Brandel.
Remember, Sean, Alabama, if this score holds up, it will only be their first conference loss. Mississippi State is unbeaten in the catbird seat, but LSU's Rondell Mealy with the touchdown, making it 7-0 LSU. Jerry DiNardo in much need of an SEC win.
Just 5 points for LSU last week in the loss to Kentucky. First time in Hal Mumme's 3 years that the Wildcats had held the opponent without a touchdown. And that warmed Coach DiNardo's seat. In Baton Rouge, Travis Henry for another first down. Jason Jones and Reggie Miles combined on the stop. Alabama and Mississippi State both undefeated in the SEC coming into today's action. It looks like Alabama's on its way to its first loss unless this one turns around in a real hurry. They do have a head-to-head battle later in the season here in Tuscaloosa. As a matter of fact, this game is the first of four straight home games for Mike DuBose and the Crimson Tide.
Mike DuBose told us, you know, all games are important, but certain games take on a little more meaning. He thought this game would really give them an accurate measurement how far they've come and how far they need to go as a program.
Henry cuts inside. Looks like a very tired defense now.
Absolutely.
And Henry's down at the 6-yard line. Jarrett Johnson, a backup defensive lineman, and Marcus Spencer combined to make the play. This is a 4-game homestand for Alabama. Southern Miss up next, and that won't be easy. They've had some memorable games in recent years, LSU and Mississippi State, before they finish with a traditional season ender against Auburn. Tennessee's now rushed for 207 yards as a team. Flag down. Second and short. Henry stopped at the 5, but there is a flag. Boy, most of that damage done in the second half. 152 yards rushing here in the second half for Philip Fulmer's team.
Offsides, defense, half the distance penalty, but a first down.
Just can't say enough about what Tennessee has done in the second half. This has been a great performance by them. You know, we were impressed when Alabama went in and beat Florida in the Swamp, but this is impressive too. Yes. Tennessee coming in here, all the hype about playing on campus in Tuscaloosa. Great, this is shaping up as a great win for Tennessee.
And they were taking on an Alabama team, particularly an offense that really was on a roll coming in with 3 straight wins against ranked opponents, 400 yards of offense in every game. The ball came out. Henry fumbled. Alabama has the ball. Did it go out of bounds? No, it did not. It was saved along the sideline by Miles and recovered by Miguel Merritt. A huge break for the Crimson Tide with 3:21 left. The first turnover in the game by either team.
Now watch the end of this play. They strung it out really well, and then Miles, as the ball comes out, it's just like when you're covering a punt or a kickoff. You know, don't let it go into the end zone. Flip it back out. I think he flipped it out with his foot.
Ball, says Mike DuBose. If they could have picked it up right away, they might have been able to run it down the side. Yeah. I think right there, Mike thought it went out of bounds, and it certainly looked like it might have. It was a very close call along the sideline. Tennessee's had a problem with fumbling. Lost one in every game. Alexander on the receiving end. He reached the 20 before Deion Grant sent him back. That ball came out, but he's ruled down by contact. after a short gain. Just one timeout left for Alabama.
Tennessee will give up all those kind of completions that Andrews Al wants to take. And the two touchdown lead, you want to keep everything in front of you right now. Even though this is a man-for-man defensive team, philosophy-wise, you'll probably see mostly zone in this situation.
Zhao steps into the throw. Shamari Buchanan has it for a first down. They'll stop the clock for a moment to move the chains. The ball out of the 30. Andre Lott had the coverage. And they're going with the hurry up, and Alexander has gone off. It looked like he got up limping a little bit after the reception on the previous play. Out of the gun, Zhao throws, caught by McCadley, can't get to the sideline, and the clock runs. Red White collared him about a yard short of a first down to the 39. 2.5 minutes left. Tennessee leads by 14.
You got to try to get something down the middle of the field, something that's going vertical down, maybe one of the slot receivers against this Tennessee defense.
Sean Bohannon has committed tailback. He makes the catch. And the Oak Ridge, Tennessee native has a first down to the 42. Mickey Allen made the stop. They're gaining yardage, but they don't have enough time to dink it down the field.
And again, Tennessee will let them dink it. I mean, they'll let them dink it all they want. They know that Alabama only has one more timeout. They need to score twice.
Zhao throws it for McCadley. Knocked down by Dwayne Goodrich. He had the best chance for it. I want to remind you that tonight on CBS, it is, as always, America's Night of Heroes, and it's all new, beginning with Early Edition. Then Samuel becomes the target of a ruthless embezzler after $6 million inexplicably appears in his bank account on an all-new martial law, followed by Chuck Norris and Walker, Texas Ranger. It's all new, and it's all tonight on CBS.
Let's go, Bama! Let's go!
Second and 10. Alabama at its own 42. Bohannon still in the game. Zhao steps up, throws, the defender fell down, Buchanan the catch. First down, and they get the momentary stop of the clock to move the chains. It was Dwayne Goodrich who fell down. First down to the Tennessee 42.
Goodrich made the play the down before this. This time he lost his footing as he was trying to come back to the receiver. And good catch by Buchanan going up in the air.
They dump it to Sean Bohannon, and they can't afford that. That's just a waste of time. That's not going to get them enough yardage, and it's going to run a lot of time. Andre Lott and Mickey Allen combined to drop Bohannon down. Zhao just can't do that.
No, it's one thing if you just need one score, but you need two scores. I mean, you got to score and kick an onside kick and try to get the football back. You got to score quickly as you can.
They have single coverage on Millens, and the ball's overthrown. Andre Lott was the corner. The safety Grant came over too late to help out. The ball was a little bit long. It'll be third down now and 12.
I've said this before. One of the great rules in college football, I think, that favors a quarterback in a situation like this is if you get a first down, the clock does stop, and it allows you to get your team back to the line of scrimmage before they reset the chains. But you can't throw too many little swing passes or things short of a first down. It just eats up way too much clock.
And they still don't have Alexander out there after he limped off several plays ago. So apparently he has suffered some sort of injury. Zhao throws too high again for Millens. Just hasn't had the same accuracy in the second half of the injured ankle. How about Alexander's Heisman hopes? Assuming it stays this way, I still think there's nothing that damaged them with 98 yards against this terrific defense.
Yeah.
That was just his rushing yardage, receiving Alexander at 6 catches for 50 yards. And we'll talk more about that in a moment, but a timeout has been called by Alabama. A few plays ago, Sean Alexander tried to run on. He took about 3 steps onto the field and went off, hobbled off. Must convert situation. Zhao throws incomplete, and Tennessee takes over on downs. They still have not allowed an opponent to convert on fourth down this year. Their opponent's now 0-for-7 on fourth down, and Mike Dubose's first 3-game winning streak as a head coach is going to end at 3.
And I think this last play is indicative of how Tennessee has played today on defense. Pressure on Andrews out. He's not been himself because of the ankle, but he's not been himself because of Tennessee's pressure as well. They live by the sword and die by the sword. It's not a defense that's geared towards allowing the offense to screw up.
With 148 yards of total offense, not a terrible day for Sean Alexander. He certainly would have gone over 100 if they weren't in the have to throw mode for almost the entire fourth quarter.
No, I don't think it kills him as a Heisman candidate, but I think he had a chance today, had Alabama won and had he had his normal kind of game, to really put himself out there as the number one guy. Mm-hmm. I think all this does today is it just kind of keeps the pack together. You know, right. Joe Hamilton was off today. He didn't play, but he's having a great year out in the Midwest. Drew Brees and Purdue's in a very close game with Penn State. You've got to assume he's playing pretty well. Ron Dayne ran for over 200 yards for Wisconsin in their big win against Michigan State. So I think all that happened today for Sean Alexander is he stayed right there in the pack.
And a few streaks to talk about. This will be 16 straight wins for Tennessee against teams from the SEC West. It'll be Tennessee's 35th straight victory when the tailback rushes for 100 yards or more. And it'll be 5 wins in a row for Tennessee against Alabama for the first time in a long, historic rivalry between these two schools. Michelle DeFoya does confirm a sprained ankle for Sean Alexander. And a very disappointing day for the Crimson Tide. But perhaps a return to form for Jamal Lewis and the Tennessee offense in the second half. They really took over the game.
They really did. They were more physical than Alabama in the second half. T. Martin made some plays. Jamal Lewis made plays. Impressive, impressive win by the Volunteers.
And undoubtedly a happy Philip Fulmer is with Michelle DeFoya.
Sean, thank you very much. Coach, a tremendous second half performance. What made the difference for you guys?
I think we got in sync offensively. You could kind of tell it at the end of the second quarter, and defensively. Hit the big play, obviously, that made him back up a little bit. There's a great throw by T and a great catch by David Martin. So just ran the football better, and our defense just played outstanding in the second half.
Yeah, you did it in spite of some significant injuries, including that to T. Martin. He played very well despite a hamstring problem.
Well, he certainly did. He's a warrior, you know, has been since he's been at Tennessee. Just really proud of the young man. I'm proud of the whole bunch of them. You know, to come here in this environment and win is a great achievement by our football team.
You mentioned in the last 24 hours that this team may still be on track to do something big this year, maybe even defend the national title. What do you see as the outlook?
There's not somebody that's just stepped up and taken over yet. You know, Florida State's a great football team. Penn State's a great football team. A lot of people up there, but why not us? You know, why not us go ahead and take off? And that's what I told to our football team, and they've bought into it. We're working hard. We've had 3 outstanding efforts the last 3 ball games we've played. Why not Tennessee again?
They are the defending champs. Back up to you, Sean.
And the schedule would give them hope too, Ty. When you look ahead, South Carolina and Notre Dame, the next 2 games at home, at Arkansas, at Kentucky, those 2 will be tough. Then they close with Vanderbilt, perhaps the SEC championship game. They are still very much in the national championship.
Absolutely. I mean, you've got some undefeated teams right now, but a lot of tough football games left for all of those undefeateds. Tennessee is, they need help, but they're certainly in good position.
An impressive win for the Volunteers. The final score, Tennessee 21 and Alabama 7. Michelle DeFoy and Todd Blackley.